Hey people, so as I said, I would make a video about the crane I made and it was shown quickly in the last video I made. So here it is. I'm gonna use this video to talk a bit about ideas for programming as well, but let's go over the crane first. So it is using the same piston technique back there, has extender pistons, rotor for rotating, and a piston for up and down. This landing gear out here is rotated by the rotor in regards to the rotor down here, the angle of that, so it will stay parallel to the ground as I move it up and down. Kind of, at least. As you may have noticed, all the rotor movements are smoothed out a bit instead of the very jagged movements they usually have, where they either move or they don't. They don't really slow up and down like a rotor does. Let's just lift this. I accidentally made the blocks out of heavy armor, which was kind of stupid because now they weigh more than the crane does. I think each block is about 110 tons. Let's just see, we are weighing 68 right now. We luck and we were weighing, yeah, about 114 tons for the box. So we can lift it very over wobbly. Yeah, this machine is run by a programmable block mostly. As I said, I can control it all. Did I say that? Anyhow, I can control all of this via the normal keyboard keys. So WASD and space and C for jump and duck to move the crane, which means I can also move all the stuff at the same time. And yeah. And that's kind of my segue into the whole program thing. I kind of want to do a little series on how to do some basic space engineers programming, which is technically basic C# programming. The reason I haven't been wanting to do that is because I am exceedingly poor at it. By that I mean I am self-taught in all the programming I know. And especially with space engineers, I have not used it for any other application. I'm not that strong in it, but I can make stuff like this work. So I think I will be able to guide enough to give a basic understanding of how to access stuff. I think instead of doing a really long video, I am going to do it in some smaller videos, like an introduction of how I do the programming, which environment, stuff like that, how to get that set up, and then on to how to access different blocks, set states, make a piston extend, do stuff with the displays and the cockpits, which we can now manipulate. And yeah, there we go. And then continue on to some functional logic, statement logic, if statements, for statements, basically make the code check for things. So for example, check is the landing gear ready to lock. If it is, then do something. Or in the case of my pistons here, basically if I am pressing the retract button, then is it retracting slower than the max speed? In that case, increase the retraction speed, stuff like that. And I think that is mostly the scope of what I'm going to do. I may do some methods. I'm not gonna do objects and stuff like that because I'm really not that strong in it, and I'm not sure that space engineers programming block even supports it. So yeah, I'm going out of a bit of tangent, but basically I think I'm gonna make three or four videos on programming. And yeah, if anyone has some specific suggestions, like a specific thing they would like to be able to do in space engineers, make a comment and I'll see if I can replicate it just as a practice example. Yeah, I think that is it. This is gonna be in the description below in a workshop link. I'm gonna link the entire world because, as you know, blueprints and multiple grids don't work that well. As for the controls, as I said, it's just WASD as you're used to for moving your character. space and control for extension retraction, and one for locking. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and thank you for watching. So, see ya.